The SQL Server IaaS extension is going to allow you to get more Azure benefits out of your SQL running in Azure virtual machines. Learn more on this episode of Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Pam LaHood, a program manager on the Azure Data team. Pam, thanks so much for joining us today.
Hi, Anna. I'm happy to be here.
Awesome. We are happy to have you here. And today we're going to be talking about the SQL Server IaaS extension. So I'd love to just kick it off by asking you, what is the SQL Server IaaS extension?
Sure. Well, so the SQL Server IaaS extension is a free add-on service that you get when you're running SQL Server in a virtual machine in Azure. And so the idea behind the extension is to give you some value add services if you decide to run your SQL Server in an Azure VM. So you can get some of the same experiences that you would get if you were in a full PaaS service like Azure SQL DB or Azure SQL Managed Instance. We want to give you a little bit of that Azure goodness, even if you're managing your own SQL Server.
Cool. I mean, that seems like a pretty good thing. You know, can you tell us a little bit more about why people would want to enable it? Kind of what is that Azure goodness you're talking about?
Sure, absolutely. Why don't we go over to the demo? Because it's probably easier if I show you versus
that'd be great.
Just talking about it. Yeah, okay. So what I have up here is my Azure portal, and I'm looking at some of my virtual machines. And so if you're running virtual machines where you've self-installed SQL Server, this may be the only view of Azure virtual machines that you know. And so you can see I have two virtual machines here. And if I were to click on one of these virtual machines, I can manage them in the regular virtual machine blade. And the virtual machine blade will give me access to things like networking and disks and the size of the VM and CPU. And it shows me all the stuff about the VM itself. But you'll notice there's nothing here that's SQL specific. So there's no way to manage anything related to SQL Server in the virtual machine because we don't know that it's running SQL, right? So let me go back to the virtual machine blade here, and I can show you, of course it changes my resource group there. Let me just go back to just my VMs. Okay. Okay, so there's my two VMs. Now, if I choose this one, the full RP, I'm gonna open this in a new tab this time so I learn my lesson about the view. So this is going to bring up one of my virtual machines where I actually have the IaaS agent extension installed. And so there'll be a slight difference for this virtual machine. If I scroll down in the window here, you'll notice there's an additional button here for SQL Server configuration. If I click this, this allows me to switch over to the SQL virtual machine blade. The SQL virtual machine blade is what you get. The SQL virtual machine resource comes with the SQL IaaS agent extension. So when you install the SQL IaaS agent extension, then you get this additional blade that allows you to manage SQL Server specific services. And so here you can see I have the ability to look at some configurations. I can change things like licensing. So in this case, this is an Azure hybrid benefit virtual machine, which means I'm leveraging my on-prem software assurance licenses in Azure. So I'm able to use my existing investments to lower my costs in Azure. So I can change my licensing if I want to go back to pay-as-you-go, or the HADR license type, which allows you to run like a passive secondary, like, for example, an availability group with a secondary machine that's passive, I can give a free HADR license if I have Azure Hybrid Benefit. So I can change all of that here, the addition, the storage configuration. So there's some basic, after the VM is deployed, there are a few things I can do using the storage configuration, like extending the drives. And also a new feature that we're excited about is the integration of Security Center and the vulnerability assessment directly in the SQL virtual machine blade. This is cool because it can be sometimes challenging when you have the Azure Defender installed and you have the vulnerability assessment for VM. It can sometimes be challenging to find the recommendations that apply to your specific VM when you go directly to Security Center. So here we'll be able to see all of the vulnerability assessment recommendations and rules that have fired. And you can see all of that directly in the SQL Virtual Machine Blade. So it's kind of a one-stop shop for managing your SQL VM.
Definitely. It's really cool. It seems like there are a lot of things there. There are also some things you didn't click on that also seem very interesting. So one other question I have, maybe this is more general, just to make sure myself and the viewers understand. This is the SQL IaaS extension. So this is something you have to go like install. Like, how do you set this up? And do you have to set it up for all your SQL virtual machines? Or is there like a way to think about what to use, what needs it?
Yeah, so that's a really great question. So to me, one of the primary benefits of the extension is discoverability. So, you know, a lot of times you may have, especially if you have a large company, a large enterprise organization, you may not even know all the VMs that you have. And so if you come over here to the SQL Virtual Machines Blade, you'll see only one of my SQL VMs is listed here. And that's because the other one doesn't have the extension. So what I can do is there's a button here called Automatic SQL Server VM Registration. And what this does is it pops up a EULA, a little agreement that you just agreed to that says, if I click accept here and I click register, then I want to automatically discover all of the virtual machines that are running SQL Server. This way, you'll have a single pane of glass where you can view everything. And this is the quickest and easiest way to get the IaaS extension on all of your Azure VMs, on all of your SQL VMs.
So it'll install it for you.
Yep. We will install it for you. And that's for all current VMs and future VMs. So if in the future you spin up a VM and you manually install SQL Server, a day or two after that VM comes online, we'll go ahead and install the extension for you. And that way you'll have a one place to manage everything for that subscription. I mean, you can manually install it. So I do have, and this is probably a little bit small, so let me zoom here. I have an Azure CLI command here up, and this is one way to manually install the extension. So that other VM where I don't have it manually, where I don't have the extension installed, I can go ahead and run this command. And then this will go and install the extension, and then eventually it'll show up. It takes a little bit of time, so it might not show up in time for our video to be, before our video is done here, but I'll just let that kick in the background. So you can also manually install it if you just want to do one or two, but I highly recommend this automatic registration, quickest and easiest way.
Yeah, I was not aware of that. Seems like, kind of like the obvious, well, just do that one button. And there you go.
That's the easy button. We call it the easy button.
I love it. Cool. So this has been really useful. Learned a lot about, the SQL IaaS extension. Another question I have for you is like, if I'm a customer and like I have SQL VMs, but I also have SQL managed instances, maybe I have SQL databases, maybe some Elastic pools. Are there any benefits now that I have the SQL IaaS extension for like kind of seeing all those things or managing all those things together?
Yeah, that's a really great question. Let's go back to the demo and I can show you, I'm here on my virtual machine blade. Let me just go home and you can go to Azure SQL. SQL VM is part of the Azure SQL family. So the Azure SQL family includes all of your SQL virtual machines, your managed instances, and your SQL databases. So when you have the IaaS extension installed, you can use this Azure SQL view to see all of your Azure SQL, whether it's PaaS, IaaS, anything you have here, and you can see information about all of those instances here. And this is particularly good if you're using Azure Hybrid Benefit, because you can apply those Azure Hybrid Benefits to PaaS services as well. So this is a nice way to see just how many instances of Azure SQL you have out there.
Cool. Awesome. This is a great view. I think most people should go ahead and just pin that Azure SQL view.
That's what I do.
Yeah, me too. So Pam, this has been so useful. I've learned a lot. I love how succinct you've been in teaching us about the SQL IaaS extension. For our viewers who are maybe new to this or just getting started, do you have any like final advice or tips and tricks on how to use the SQL IaaS extension?
I would just say, try it out. It's a free service. It's kind of a no-brainer. It's a free service. You get all of these extra value adds. There's a lot of stuff that we didn't talk about, things like automated backups, automated security patching, and we've got new features coming all the time. We're working very hard to implement all kinds of different value add features that just make it quick and easy to manage your SQL VM. So I highly recommend you opt into this and take a look at the features we have available today, and then keep an eye out for what's coming in the future.
That's awesome. Thanks so much, Pam. I think, you know, it sounds like we're going to get closer and closer to kind of adding like PaaS-like capabilities to IaaS, which is cool for a lot of people who still want that extra control.
Yep, very cool. So we call it IaaS++.
IaaS++. Love it. Awesome. Well, thanks so much, Pam, for coming on the show. For our viewers, thanks for watching. In the description, we're going to put some links so you can learn more about the SQL IaaS extension, how to get it set up, and how to get the most out of it. And with that, we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.